New at 5 tonight, he's made you laugh, he's made you cry, and also think for more than three decades. But tonight, a local cartoonist is cutting back.
And News 5's John London talked with Jim Borgman today. And John, why the change at the Inquirer?
Well, economy, Cherie, and it dovetails with his desire to stop and smell the roses. Tonight, Jim Borgman in transition.
He doesn't have to draw it, he can sense it.
Newspapers are changing.
Jim Borgman.
Everybody's trying to understand where the news business is going, and you can feel it here every day.
When he started 32 years ago, he was one of 350 political cartoonists in America. As his latest thought provoker hits your doorstep this morning, he's one of about 60.
The profession itself is evaporating before our eyes, and I find myself wondering what's going to happen to editorial cartooning.
He's been going full tilt for 12 years, daily cartoons and his comic strip Zits. So as the Inquirer offered voluntary severance to cut expenses, he bit. He will still do a Sunday feature, but this community's morning ritual, its cup of daily Borgman, is changing.
I kind of feel like an old married couple with this town. You know, we sit down together over breakfast and have done it every day for 32 years, and sometimes we have a lot to say, and sometimes we have a little to say. The great American debate is what this has all been about.
He smiles as he thinks of a saner lifestyle, as he puts it, perusing the paper without a highlighter in hand or an agenda in mind. On the other hand, it's part of the portrait Cincinnati draws its own wit and wisdom from.
I know the day isn't too far off when I see a story and an idea comes to my mind, and I may not have the same forum now to express my thought. And I suspect there are some twinges ahead as I get used to that.
And Jim Borgman's last daily drawing will be in about 3 weeks. He'll do a new Sunday feature, and he emphasizes that he values and treasures his relationship with this town.